Welcome girls. The next question in your syllabus, that is, write a detailed note on hydrosphere, or which is also called as hydrarch. So in previous lecture we have discussed about the plant succession. What is plant succession? Tell me the answer. What is plant succession? What is plant succession?
The process of development of new communities in an individual area is called as plant succession.
Okay, so development of the new community. Then we have discussed about the different characteristics of the plant succession. Then we have discussed about the different factors that will be affected to the plant succession. And last time we have discussed about the types of the plant succession. So which are the types of plant succession?
Primary succession, secondary succession,
right.
Autotrophic
succession, then और कौन से टाइप्स है? टोटल सिक्स है. एलोजेनिक सक्सेशन. और दो कौन से है?
हेटेरोट्रॉफिक सक्सेशन एंड सेकेंडरी सक्सेशन.
राइट. सो हेटेरोट्रॉफिक और ऑटोट्रॉफिक सक्सेशन, दीज आर द टाइप्स ऑफ प्लांट सक्सेशन. So in lastly we have discussed about the shear. So in shear there is a different habitat. On basis of the habitat, these communities or development of the communities from pioneer stage to the climax stage have been again differentiated as a hydrosphere or gerosphere. Hydrosphere, that means the plant succession that will be start in the water habitat, for example ponds, lake and marshy places. So the and if the plant succession that will be started in the saline soil or saline water, then which is called as halosphere. Then the main second type is the gerosphere. That means the succession of the plant or the process of the succession that will be start in the dry habitat or the where the optimum water supply will be present. So again the gerosphere has differentiated into samospheres or lithospheres. Samospheres, that means the life or succession will be start on the sand, and lithospheres, that means succession process that will be initiate on the rocky surfaces. So in that two types, hydrospheres and gerospheres, we have discussed one by one. First of all, the hydrosphere, or which is also called as the hydrarch. So in this hydrosphere, the various serial stages in aquatic habitats such as ponds, lakes and marshy constitute the hydrosphere. जहाँ से aquatic water में जहाँ पे life start हो जाती है, these are called the hydrosphere. Then these can be studied in the pond, where the, as you know, the pond structure, the pond that will be very deep at the middle place and they will be shallower at the towards the bank side. So jo surrounding area hai wahan pe shallow surface rehta hai, aur jo center region rehta hai very deep region rehta hai. So here we have discussed the hydrosphere regarding the pond. So in hydrosphere, the hydrosphere succession that will be begins with the pioneers and terminates in a climate community. So any area jahan pe succession hota hai, that succession that will be initiated at the pioneer community, and they will be terminate at the climax community. That means terminate at the stable community. So here the depth of the pond that will be decreases at the bed of the pond in red. जैसे ही pond बड़ा होता जाता है, pond का area यदि large है, at that time the surface, the surrounding surface of that pond or the depth of that pond that will be decreases. So here the depth of the pond that will be decreased at this if the bed of the pond that will be raised. Then the material stages in hydrosphere are as so how actually the process or the succession process that will be takes place, we have discussed one by one. The first stage in the succession is the pioneer stage. The first community to have a developed, this community that will be called as pioneer stage. So in pioneer, the early colonizers are the phytoplankton like blue green algae, diatoms, bacteria, etc. Then some paramecium, amoeba and verticillia, which feeds on phytoplankton. They can appear in the pond water. Then the dead pioneer forms a layer of the mud at the bottom. So in pioneer stage, एकदम स्मॉल जो फाइटोप्लैंक्टन है, फाइटोप्लैंक्टन इज वेरी स्मॉल ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट इन द प्लांट. सो फॉर एग्जांपल ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गी, सो ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गी इट इज अ सिंगल सेल्ड एल्गी. सो जो स्मॉलर ऑर्गेनिजम है आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस पायनियर स्टेज एंड दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द कॉलोनी. And they can form also live in algae, plants as well as animals. And small animals like paramecium, amoeba, verticillata, these are also a pioneer. They are also the initial communities which are present here. So that they plant as well as animals, they are present at that stage and they can grow on that stage, and after some time they will be dead and they can form the mud at that layer, and this is muddy bottom that will be developed at the sides of ponds. Then after the pioneer stage, there is the submerged stage. Submerged stage, that will be soft muddy beds that will be developed at the bottom of the bottom or as a dead and decaying. So phytoplanktons and the soil particles that will be eroded from the surrounding bank. And the new habitat is comparatively shallow and inhabited by submerged plants like the hydrilla, ceratophyllum, vallisneria, urticaria, podomyelita, etc. The plants that should be grow on that site. So they spread rapidly through the vegetative propagation and to form the mass of the resist the current of the water, and they can hold the eroded soil material. The submerged plant sinks to the bottom and they can build up the substratum. Simultaneously, the habitat becomes less suitable to the existing plants as the pond has become shallower, and the new habitat that will be replaced the submerged plants by the floating plants. So here फर्स्ट स्टेज में हमने देखा जो पायोनियर स्टेज में वहाँ पे कुछ स्मॉलर ऑर्गेनिज्म लाइक फाइटोप्लैंक्टन्स, कुछ ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गी वहाँ पे ग्रो हो रही है, उनके साथ में कुछ एनिमल्स वहाँ पे हमें पैरामेशियम लाइक एनिमल्स वहाँ पे ग्रो हो रहे, उनकी ग्रोथ होने के बाद उनके जो डेथ होते हैं, डेथ डिके होने के बाद वहां पे एक एट द बॉटम वहां पे मरी सरफेस तैयार हो रहा है। उसके बाद आती है सबमर्स फेज। सबमर्स फेज में जो मरी पेड़ वहां पे पॉन्ड के जो बॉटम है, बॉटम पे वहां पे मरी पेड़ तैयार हो रहा है। तो ड्यू टू दिस मरी पेड़ द डिफरेंट प्लांट्स दैट विल बी ग्रो लाइक द हाइड्रिला, थेरेटोफाइलम, हेलिथ्रिया लाइक प्लांट्स दे विल बी ग्रो ऑन देयर साइड एंड दिस प्लांट्स वेयर grow very fastly because the plants will be propagated with the vegetative propagation. So the mass or the diversity of the plant that will be increased at the submerged level, and due to this the water that resists these water currents, and that's why the material that will be eroded out, and this plant that all submerged plants they can grow in that area in pond, they will be build up the whole substrate and the base level, they can cover all bottom level of the pond. And then due to this habitat becomes the less suitable, so the existing plant of that area that will be replaced by the another community. This is वहाँ पे सब submerged plant grow होंगे तो उनके उनके बीच में वहाँ पे competition हो जाए, और due to this competition वहाँ पे new community वहाँ पे develop हो जाएगी जो कि floating stage होगी, क्योंकि सभी plant अभी वहाँ पे submerged stage में ही है, तो उनके बीच में कंपटीशन हो रहा है। तो एट द सेम टाइम वहाँ पे न्यू कम्युनिटी एंटर कर रही है कि जो फ्लोटिंग होगी, फ्लोटिंग होगी मतलब वो सरफेस पे जो पॉन्ड का ऊपर का सरफेस है, ऊपर के सरफेस पे आएगी। तो नेक्स्ट इज अबाउट द फ्लोटिंग स्टेज। सो इन फ्लोटिंग स्टेज द वाटर डेप्थ इज अबाउट 4 to 8 feet बाय द एंड ऑफ सबमर्स स्टेज। The submerged plant they can be moved into deeper layer. The area once inhibited by submerged plant is now they can form in the colonize, and by floating these plants have their rhizomes, root stock and root anchored at the bottom. As you know, the floating plant they are attached at the bottom because they are having strong root system, and due to the strong root system they can attach at the bottom, but their two vegetative part, these vegetative part grow on above the water surface. So in this way these floating plants that can be anchoring at the bottom, but their leaves that all are spreading over the surface of the water. So in the floating state, different plants like the Nymphaea, Dendrophia, Monocornea, Ranunculus, Icornea, Pistia, different types of plants, floating plants that will be grows and the floating stage. Mostly jo plants having the broad leaves, they can be floating or they can be easily spreading over the surface of the water. So due to this floating plant or the leaves of this floating plant, they can cover the all water surface, and due to they covering all water surface, ultimately they can interact the light. सो जो प्लांट बॉटम में ग्रो हो रहे थे, दिस सबमर्ज प्लांट हमने देखे क्यों पॉन्ड्स के बॉटम में, तो जो बॉटम में जो प्लांट है उनको लाइट मतलब वहां पे वो ज्यादा लाइट रिसीव नहीं कर सकते, तो अल्टीमेटली दे विल बी तो वहां पे जो होल्ड डीपर एरिया है, ऑन दैट एरिया ड्यू टू जो सबमर्ज प्लांट है, जो फ्लोटिंग प्लांट है, फ्लोटिंग प्लांट की वजह से वो पानी के अंदर जो भी प्लांट्स है सबमर्ज प्लांट्स उसको लाइट नहीं मिल रही है, तो जो वहाँ पे जो प्लांट ग्रो है जो उनके ग्रोथ पे उसका अफेक्ट होगा। तो अल्टीमेटली जो सबमर्ज प्लांट है, सबमर्ज प्लांट कहाँ पे शिफ्ट होंगे कि जहाँ से वो लाइट रिसीव कर सकते। तो यहाँ पे जो होल डीपर एरिया है, सबसे डीप एरिया है, वहाँ पे ये सबमर्ज प्लांट शिफ्ट हो जाते हैं, और जो साइड एरिया है वहाँ पे ये हमारे फ्लोटिंग प्लांट्स ग्रो हो जाते हैं। देन रीड स्वैम स्टेज, रीड स्वैम स्टेज दैट मीन्स इट डेवलप्स द एम्फीबियंस प्लांट। एम्फीबियंस प्लांट मतलब जो प्लांट्स वाटर में और सॉइल में दोनों तरफ जो प्लांट्स अच्छे से ग्रो हो सकते हैं उसे बोलते हैं एम्फीबियस प्लांट्स। सो एम्फीबियस प्लांट्स लाइक द क्राइपस एंड ट्राइफा, प्रैग्माइटिस, सैगिटेरिया, दिस ऑल आर द रील स्वैम प्लांट एंड दे कैन ग्रो अप टू द 4 feet डेप्थ ऑफ द पॉन्ड एंड दे आर हैविंग the rhizomic rhizome root stock and root ramifying densely in the soil to prevent any erosions of the soil. So on the side area of the ponds these reed stage that will be developed and they can grow the amphibious or amphibious plants. Then the depth of these water is very much reviewed in course the time rendering the substratum unfit for the seeds. Then after some time due to this depth of the water, the site also will be unfit for seeds of that amphibious plants. Then fifth stage is the sage meadow stage, or which is also called as the marshy stage. So here in marshy stage, due to the successive decrease in the water level or further changes in the substratum, species of cypresses, some gramineae family members like the iliocaris, then porex, gencus, cypress, etc. like these plants that will be grow in the colony and they can form the thick vegetation which is surroundings of this or the border of these ponds. So here the aerial emergent part causing the rapid loss of the water and removal of the surface water from the substratum. So it is somewhat shrubby plants, that's why they can easily absorb the water and they can develop the new substratum or they can easily or fastly absorb in the water, that's why they can disturb it or they can remove in the surface water from the substratum. So here some plants like in the substratum of that ponds is exposed to air and light. So here the plants like the mint, campanella, iris, etc. they can grow and they will be mixed in this stage. So here in sage meadow stage or marshy stage, some members or shrubby plants like members of the cypressy and gramineae family they will be grow. With this some smaller plants like mint, campanula, they are also grow on that side. Then next one is the woodland stage. So here in woodland stage, that means you have jo woody plants hai, that can be developed. So as the soil is exposed, will be jo pond ka jo side area hai, then it will be dried and the organic matter they will be radially composed. So the area is now added by The land plants like the acacia, terminalia, salix, populus, etc. So the woodland stage, the woody plants that will be added at that area, and they will be reacted on this habitat. They react on that habitat, and in which they will be rendered and unsuitable for the woodland stage plants. So here the and last stage is the forest stage, or forest stage, which is also called as a climax stage or stable stage. So here the after the woodland community is invaded by several trees plant, and this trees plant grows in the soil, and they are the rich, having the rich food chain and humus. So the trees grow denser on dry as well as in well aerated soil. In tropical climate, there is the heavy rainfall, develops tropical rainforest. In temperate region, develops mixed type of forest, and that mostly the plants like ulmus, then acer or fucus like plants that will be developed. Then in region where the minimum or the moderate rainfall, that will be moderate rainfall will be followed. At that place, some tropical deciduous forest that will be developed. Deciduous, that means those plants, they are having the leaf falling. जो leaf falling और leaf senescence हो जाता है, वैसे forest वहाँ पे बन सकते हैं. Then the growth of these shade loving plants also favorable, as that light is cut off and canopy of the forest. Well, in forest area, as you know, the various large trees that will be developed. So on that large trees, some epiphytes or some orchid like plants that will be grow on that plant because of minimum light and high moisture content of that area. Then area, if once under the deep water is occupied by forest community, they can provide the climate with the moist. So here the moist climate that will be developed due to this development of the climax community. So in this way, in the hydrosphere, the different stages, due to the formation of the different stages one by one, the stable community that will be developed from the hydrosphere habitat. So ultimately, from hydrosphere, the habitat that will be changed out, and every time the new community that will be replaced by the one coming. So here I can stop. In next lecture, we are discuss about the remaining part of the hydrosphere. So I can here stop my sharing.